lor. Is it worth the time for you to actually look? Or you know, even the social media, you know, just now somebody told me, you know, what's this WhatsApp and all that? Messaging too? Ada siapa pernah pakai WhatsApp tu? Ah, okay. Because the face look at me that it seems I heard it for the first time. Okay, do you know why people use WhatsApp?
Free.
Ah, very fast and free, eh? So you self answer yourself, why people start adopting the tools? When it's deliverables, it's fast, that means service. And free means no cost money to you, so you got no barriers to implement it or something. The only barrier is either your data plane tak cukup or your area memang tak ada data lah. Right, so that's where when you go area like network not so good, maybe in Terengganu we have to find out. Yeah, because people there I saw they still use the Nokia 3310. Ah, betul ke tak? I just see one or two ah, but I don't know about the rest ah. So I'm just doing a very small sample niche. But that generation still exists. No, so that tells me what kind of mentality of people when we come across. So you know, that's one. And then of course that for management, bottom line return, especially to your stakeholders, they will always ask about return on investment. What actually is the real return? Return of brand, return of people, or return of dollar and cents? Which one is the one? No, so that one, how does it affect everyone? Very simple. When you put on the ROI, tomorrow your bonus will be affected by this. Right? Then the staff will be very pressure. No? You won't pressure, they won't pressure. Okay, common sense, fundamental issues. This is pure money and sense. So let's just ask a simple question here. For our hospitals, what is the real key performance index for your organizations to be measured as good? I assume this one you should know. Because related to your job scope. Like what is the real measurement that says that you know your hospitals are based on these factors that
data.
Says that? All right?
Data.
No, I mean your KPI.
KPI.
What is the organization KPI? Because Mr. Abel did highlight to me that you have two main KPIs to achieve. In all three hospitals, you have a standard two KPIs. Okay. So I keep it here, huh? In these four walls, Okay. So can I say that the item one and item number two, does it applies to all of you? So first up, when you go objective, you need to make sure that does it make sense to your these two organization KPI, first and foremost. Because if you don't understand the relationship, then you don't see a meaning why you should implement it, right? I can't just tell you all the good things, but I don't relate to you what is this means to you, then it's obviously meaningless to have implementation. So one thing is, what do you mean by conversion rate from your organization standpoint? Does anyone can tell me? Conversion rate to
how many impressions can you generate from the conversion?
Is it from the hospitals, like specifically is it outpatients? So then you can define this is the KPI inpatient. Okay, then how do you define customer satisfaction index? Like how do you actually say that? Sorry?
Feedback.
How do you get the feedback?
Analysis of the customer's feedback.
Okay, so do you use a form of survey forms to analyze the feedback?
Yes.
So does the survey form later, you correlate with the Google rating, does it make sense to that purpose? Because you need to compare apple to apple, right? You can't just take something and it doesn't make sense to you in your original work. Okay, that is what I would do more because it's not easy to settle one day workshop, no. Okay, but understanding the relationship between this will be very critical. Okay, so conversion like just now, for me, it could mean 20% more customer comes in through social media. For your case, outpatient, I understand it's the patient that discharged, is it, from the hospital?
No.
Oh, sorry, from the...
Outpatient, how many can
you bring as inpatient? Oh, that means they get themselves come in and check in at your center, registration counter.
Rather than they come in to for consultation, then suddenly they want to be admitted somewhere else. We don't want that to happen.
Okay, so maybe part of the conversion you may analyze is that why does the customer come in and decide to go somewhere else? Do you ask any question of that? Why he changed his mind after he comes in? So this is what you can do investigation on social media. Maybe they comment, they saw some feedback in forum, they may talk something. So we will find that out later. Okay, we do some real demo, but that's what we mean. And then satisfaction means, does generally your pattern customer is satisfied with hospital, or you think they can be improved? Or maybe because using social media, the response rate is faster, you know, you need to equip with something that both parties understand, like person who use it and the customer also understands it. Okay, if customer complains, says that my satisfaction, I complain is 200, is it good or bad? You know, this is just a general statement, right? But is it good or bad? Ni pun tak ada jawapan juga, and so that means the answer, it could be depends. How many percent of that 200 is good? How many percent 200 is the bad one? Then you can make a more sensical figures, right, when you do that index analysis. So maybe for the work, some numbers will create more sense. Okay, so for this says later you have. Okay, this is what we call as an awareness path program. So basically, most organizations, they start with here, where nobody knows who they are. Okay, that's why it's called visibility. Google tak dapat cari, so that's why it happens. And then when, let's say, the some hospitals are built very well, I know the Kuala Terengganu is built very well. There's a very lot of likes inside. So that's the engagement factor comes in. That means how close your relationship or, you know, constant touch with your customer. Like, customer likes to be keep in contact with. And then, like your reputation. Does your hospital is well known for complaints on certain things? Most likely good things, they won't say so much lah, but you Google bad things are very fast, they can see your hospital. So I Google the hospital name later, I can validate that. This is how we find out, you know, you don't need to type so hard, you just type the hospital name and then we see from there. This is the feedback. And then if your job is purely bringing in outdoor patients most of the time, then, you know, how does the end result comes in? But the end result won't come in until the first three layers are both being addressed. Okay, so that depends on where you are at this point of time. And of course, one makes sense is market condition as well, like customer and competitor movement. Like, so you need all the information to make it make sense. So anyone has seen outside Malaysia, maybe they want to compare with this general hospital. So what makes this SGH so well known is, let's say, you know, Singapore, right? And then Singapore and Malaysia, right? So what's the difference between Malaysia and Singapore hospitals? Unless the cost more lah. Price too memang diorang memang sepuluh kali ganda lebih mahal kan. But why people prefer to go to them, even though they charge more?
Quality of service.
Okay, and then? Yeah. So we use it, exercise later, we just bear SGH in mind because SGH is well known for hospital industry, he's very well known. Okay, aside from it's very rich. Okay, but and then this one, have you come across this company? PKT Logistics. Okay, PKT is a warehouse industry. Okay, warehouse, as you know, it stores the barang-barang which is not so appealing to mass market. Okay, it's just like store normal goods and transportation, consulting, logistics. But why does he go on Facebook? No such industry with target customer. This customer is a business to business. Why does he go to Facebook? So marketing people, I just show you his site. What does normally people say? So every